Good morning. We bring you greetings from the Pilgrim Rest Missionary Baptist Church, 977 Chase Street, Gary, Indiana, where we are live streaming from our home. Pastor Charles E. Adams Jr. and Lady Kim Adams. Pastor Adams will be bringing our message on this morning, and we hope that you enjoy it. We realize that this coronavirus have us locked in, but we are never locked out from God's arms of protection. And we thank God for each of you all that will be listening on this morning. God bless you.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come now, oh God, we thank you. We praise you for this opportunity that you have given us, oh God, just to be able to encourage your people, oh Lord, through these means. So God, we pray now that the word that we share, oh God, will certainly be a blessing to the hearer, that it will encourage us even in a difficult time, that we can still trust in our God. So God, we pray in your name that you will use us now, and not only this servant, we pray for every servant right now who is doing the same to reach out to your people. So God bless us now. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I greet you this morning, and the one who has certainly saved us, the one who has redeemed us, and the one we give all our praises to. I do want to thank my wife, certainly, for that introduction. As she said, we are not home at the church like we consider, but we are at home where we live and reside, and so we thank God for being able to reach out in this manner today. But I do come now because I know it is a challenging time for all the people of God, but it is also a time for us also to thank him that he's a God that's present at all times. So I pray today that what I will share today will certainly be something that will help each of us to keep our trust in the God that we serve. Because this past week, it has been a week that I have tried to examine, tried to look at, and tried to focus in God about a way in which I could say something that would just give encouragement today. And so there's a passage scripture that I would like you to look at with me today. Those who are listening out there through Facebook or the live stream, that there is a word today that is most familiar to many of us. And it comes from the book of Philippians chapter 4, verses 11 through 13 is what we want to read to you right now. It says, not that I speak in respect of want, but I have learned in whatsoever state I am, therewith to be content. I know both how to be abased, I know how to abound. Everywhere in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and suffer need. I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. And today, just by way of subject, I want to talk about being confident and being content. Being confident and content. When we find ourselves, and we are certainly living in some unusual times, the whole world is faced with a pandemic of epic proportions. Many are wondering, how do we react to it? Some are panicking and some are afraid. Which are normal reactions to this type of emergency? Yet, in spite of these emotional issues, this scripture is truly a lesson for dealing with and responding to the complexities of our lives. It is Paul, and I think many of us are familiar with him. He writes these words. And Paul is very personal and very passionate about what he is saying from this text, because he personally tells us how to be content. And I do believe there was some confidence in what Paul was saying, because that's why I said being confident and content, it means that both work together. Because when you look at what he says, content, according to this particular text, means self-sufficient or to be satisfied. This contentment was not developed through his own power or might. It was the result of someone who was greater than Paul. And I pray those who are listening to me today understand there is someone greater than these circumstances. There's someone greater than this coronavirus. And that's someone that we have to acknowledge and have to trust is the Lord our God. Because I just believe that if it is God who brought us to this, that same God will bring us through it. I mean, that's confidence, that's contentment, because that's saying to you that I'm satisfied with the Lord. And so as we look at this more today, the trust we have in the Lord can compare us and prepare us for the times that we face right now. Because it's whom Paul believed that gave him this confidence. It's whom Paul believed that gave him this contentment. And one of the first things that I noticed is this, that first of all, he learned how to accept. What am I saying? He says this, not that I speak in respect or want, and that really is in respect or regards of being in need. He says this, that I have learned that whatever state I am therewith to be content. Mm-hmm. Now think about that. He says he learned how to accept. And I'm challenging you to hear me today that we got to learn how to accept whatever God allows. And I know it's difficult, even when we look at what's going on today, when there are many who are getting sick, when we have this invisible foe that we cannot detect where the foe is or who the foe is attacking. But we can be assured of this, that if we learn to trust in God, that we will learn to accept the things that come with life.
Yes.
Because listen, life is like a roller coaster at times. Life will sometimes have you up, sometimes have you down. But through the midst of what life is doing to us, my friends, remember, you can learn how to accept. Now, Paul put it this way. He says, in whatsoever state that I find myself in, I done learned to be content. And listen, the only way Paul learned to do this was through going through those experiences. Now, some of us, I know, don't want to ever go through anything, but you got to be realistic about this. If you're going to live in this world, you are going to face some trials. But what do you learn from going through them? Do they prepare you for something else that is going to come, something greater? And through it, can you learn to be satisfied? Can you learn to accept what the Lord God may allow to come? And right now, this is a time of that questioning. Can we learn to accept? And so I'm glad that when we look at what Paul shares, Paul's words came to a time in the first century where he was talking to the saints of Philippi. And this being the fourth chapter, the closing chapter of this book, Paul is now personally telling them the things that he was not ashamed to be transparent about. And so Paul, in doing this, was learning that I can accept what is happening. And so my brothers and sisters, I encourage you today to learn to do the same, because everything you accept is not going to always be easy. Everything you accept is not going to always be easy to bear. But I do assure you, if you learn to take the good and the bad, that God somewhere along the way will let you be confident and content that I can get through this. And I just want to let somebody know out there today, we're going to get through this, because our contentment is in the Lord, our God. But secondly, I see Paul learning also that I done learned how to adjust. Hear what he says in verse 12. Personally, he says, I know both how to be abased, and I know how to abound. Everywhere, in all things, I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. Now, what is Paul saying? Paul is saying that I done learned how to take the good and the bad. Listen, and I done learned how to adjust to those things. Because sometimes, you know, it's always good to live where there's plenty, live where health is doing good. But think about when those things may be taken from you. Can you also adjust to living that way? Because right now, we all are making some adjustments. Amen. We know that a month ago, it ain't like it was. We're looking at a time now that in just 3 weeks or so, our lives have changed. And now there has been some adjustments that we done had to apply. But in doing this, my friends, can we still be content? Can we still be confident in our God, knowing our God will bring us through? Yes. Now, Paul said this. He says, I know. Now, Paul speaks personally. He says for himself, and I don't know who's out there listening today, can be on the side of Paul. Have you learned to adjust? Have you learned to have, listen, a full refrigerator, and then a few weeks later have an empty refrigerator? Have you learned to do this? Learn to adjust to that. That don't you know that the God of plenty is also the same God of less? But here is what God can do in your less. He can make your less be greater than your much. And if Jesus could talk to us today, he'll tell you that I can take 2 fish, 5 loaves of bread, and make a meal to feed 5,000 besides women and children. Don't you know he's still the same God that can help us to adjust during lean times? So I just challenge you, my friends, to believe and trust God today, because listen, the God we serve has not changed. He's a God right now that is still our present help. So I'm glad that Paul shares this. And Paul wanted these believers to hear that Paul ain't always had it like you think he did. Paul was letting them know honestly that, listen, I know how to be abased. I know how to abound. And listen, he spoke from this perspective, because Paul realized that there were times in his life where he didn't have everything he wanted. But he did know this for sure, that the same God was able to supply him with that, what he needed. So isn't that good that he can still speak about the dry times in his life? And I just believe that we as believers got to know how to share those times in our lives where we struggle, where we even had questions to God, where we even had to be abased, where we even learned that in every way and all things, where we were instructed to both be full and to be hungry. Now think about that, to be full and to be hungry. Paul is saying that he learned to adjust. And life will at some point bring you where you had to learn how to adjust to your surroundings. And right now, this is almost that time. We don't know what the next weeks hold for us, but I just believe if we be confident and content that our God will show us that he will take care of us. And not only that, he's going to bring us through. And so finally, my friends, that after these things that Paul had learned, learn how to accept, learn how to adjust. Here is the answer to why he learned how. He learned how to acknowledge. Where am I going? He says this, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthened me. Listen, brothers and sisters, that's the key to the text. No matter how confident we are, no matter how content we might be, the answer is in verse 13. Listen, I couldn't do those things if it was not Christ giving me the power to do so. Anybody hear me out there today? Listen, it's through Christ we can do all things. It's through Christ that we can be confident. It's through Christ that we can have this type of contentment. And if you hear me right now, this will stir you up enough to believe that through Christ, I can do all things. And the reason I can do all things is because he gives us the strength. He gives us the power to hold on and not give up. He gives us the help when we find ourselves getting weak. Isn't he all right? Because I'm glad that Paul speaks to someone that he tried for himself. And I pray that those who are listening out there don't give up on Jesus, because Jesus is still able in a time like this. And no matter how bad the times look, I believe they look good for our God. Because in times like these, it's true we need a Savior. In times like these, I'm sure you know you need an anchor. But I'm glad that I know who the anchor is. It's Jesus.
Yes.
He's that rock.
Yes.
Certainly that song was declared in a weary land. And he certainly shelter when storms are raging. And isn't it good that Paul would take a moment like this to talk to saints, to let saints understand that whatever state you find yourself in, you can be content.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm so grateful that God is the only one who can give us that type of confidence.
Yes.
Who can give us that only content. Amen. That when times like these arise, we have a Savior. And I pray that you know that Savior. I pray that this Savior is becoming real to someone out there listening today. And that Savior, if you don't know him, is Jesus.
Yes.
He's the Son of God. He's the lily of the valley. He's the bright and morning star. He's the one who died on the rugged cross. Yes, he died there, but he didn't stay dead because they buried him. And 3 days later, he rose from the dead.
Yes,
and,
yes.
And so Paul talks about someone who is a risen Savior.
Yes, yes.
He talks about someone who saved his life.
Yes.
And I'm sharing with someone today that if he did it for Paul, he can do it for you.
Yes.
And I pray today, if you're listening today, this will give you hope.
Yes.
This will give you some assurance that the Lord we serve is a risen Savior.
Oh, yes.
I'm just glad that we are certainly upon a great time for the church.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Amen. 2 Sundays from now, we'll be celebrating Easter.
Yes, yes.
And I just thought I'll mention it right now because I don't know what 2 weeks hold from now.
Hallelujah.
But I believe if we have confidence.
Yeah, God.
Listen, and content in God.
Yeah,
that
yeah,
we
yeah.
can face what's coming on tomorrow.
Yes,
because God. We got a son, God who told us.
Yeah, God. Yeah, God.
His son, Jesus. Take no thought about tomorrow.
Yes.
Don't worry about what tomorrow Hallelujah. Might bring.
Yeah,
know
God.
Who holds your tomorrow.
Yeah, God.
And I hope that somebody hear me right now. Know who's holding their tomorrow.
Yes,
he's
yes.
holding your tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Like he's holding you in his hands.
Yeah, God.
And if you believe he's holding you, you know no weapon formed
yeah, God.
Against you
Hallelujah.
Shall prosper.
Yeah, God.
Ain't God all right?
Yes, he is.
I'm just glad that I can trust him.
Yes.
I'm glad
Hallelujah.
I can trust him. I'm glad
yeah,
I can call
God.
On him. Is there anybody
Hallelujah,
here,
God.
listening right now, knowing that our God, can be trusted.
Hallelujah, God.
Our God, can come through. Our God, can make a way won't he do it?
Hallelujah.
I just believe right now, God is going to show us.
Yes, he is.
He's going to bring us
Pastor.
Through. He's going to prove to us
Hallelujah.
Why he's God, and he's God all by himself.
Hallelujah.
I can share with somebody that God is real.
Yes.
That God is a present
yes,
help.
He is.
That God
yes, he
will
is.
Be right
hey.
There. He promised in his word that he won't leave us.
Come on, Robin.
Nor forsake
Hallelujah.
Us. Ain't he all right? I'm just glad.
Glad
I feel like Ezekiel.
Hey.
I have a congregation before me right now.
Yeah,
he told him, just speak the word.
Yes.
You preach to the
Hallelujah.
Bones, and watch the word of God give life to them.
Preach, Robin.
I pray
Hallelujah.
That somebody listening out there will get some life through the word of God. Will be convinced that God can give you contentment. That God should give you confidence.
Hallelujah.
He's the God,
God.
That promised
to
walk with us.
Yeah.
A God that promised to take care of us. So I thank God today for this moment.
Yes, Lord.
Just
yes, Lord.
To share.
Hallelujah.
Just to encourage.
Hey.
Just to tell
Come
somebody
on, Robin.
Everything
Preach.
Is going to be all right.
Yeah,
have a God of witness.
Preach, Robin. Hallelujah,
thank
God.
You,
yes, God.
Thank
Hallelujah,
you, Lord.
God.
Thank
Woo,
you.
Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Mm.
For being
yeah,
able to share
glory.
This day.
Mm.
I pray that what we have
yeah,
given
glory.
Today by way of a message
yeah.
that it will certainly give confidence
yes, oh God.
And content to someone right now.
Yes, oh God.
I assure you we can still be satisfied.
Yes, oh God.
Because our satisfaction, it comes from the Lord.
Yes, oh God.
So in times like these, God can give you some contentment.
Yes, he can.
He can let you be
Hallelujah,
assured.
Hallelujah, God.
That we're going to get through this.
Yes, we are.
He's going to heal the lame.
Mm, yes, he is.
And
yes, he
just
is.
Just keep praying.
Hallelujah, God.
God is going to heal the lame.
Yeah, God.
And he's going to take care of his people.
God.
And some souls will
God.
Be saved.
Yeah, God.
And the kingdom of God will be blessed.
Yes, oh God.
So as I get ready to bring this to a close, I do want to thank you for listening.
Yes.
Thank you for just receiving this word today. I know we're not able to be at our physical structure, but thank God that the church is the church.
Yes, Lord.
Wherever he or she may gather. And so, church, let's praise him this day.
Yes.
And let's give glory to his name. For the Lord our God is good. His mercy endured forever.
Yes, Lord.
I want to say to all of you, Pilgrim Rest, all of those that might have been listening
yes,
for me
Lord.
And Lady Kim, we want to say we love you.
We
our
love you. We love you.
You.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for sharing with us at
yes,
this hour.
Oh God.
And we're going to close with prayer right now just to say to God, thank you, and just to encourage someone. Let us pray. God, our Father, we thank you certainly for using us, for sharing, oh God, for these minutes.
Yes, God.
God, we pray now as we come to a close, God, that you will certainly help and
yes,
heal
oh God.
Today.
Yes, God.
There are people who are hurting. There are people
yes,
who
oh
are
God.
Seeking. There are people who are in need, but you are our help. And so, God, we call on
yes,
you
God.
Because we want you, Lord, to move
Ooh, yes, oh
through
God.
The land. We want you to heal. Through the land. We
yes,
want
God.
You, Lord, to save.
Yes, oh God.
Through the land. We want
yes,
you
oh
to
God.
Deliver
yes,
through
oh
the
God.
Land, oh God. We want you, Lord, to let somebody
Hallelujah,
be blessed
God.
By what they have heard
yes,
this day. That they can be confident and they can be content.
Yes, God.
Because they ought to know that Jesus is the source of
yes,
that contentment.
Yes, so God. Yes, so God.
Because it's through him we can do all things.
Yes.
So God, we thank him for giving us the power.
Yes, God.
For giving us the victory, oh God.
Yes, God.
Just to proclaim your word.
Yes, so
and
God.
Do your will.
Yes, God.
So God, I pray that you bless my yes. church family.
Yes, so God.
Bless the body of Christ.
Oh, God. Yes, God.
Bless this entire world
yes,
right now.
Yes, yes.
Help us through this, oh God.
Yes, God.
And the Lord, when you do it for your glory.
Yes, oh God.
And let us give you the praise.
Yes.
It's in Jesus' name we pray. We thank God.
In Jesus' name.
And amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you, my friends. Y'all stay encouraged. And let the good Lord God bless you real good.
God bless.
So long, my friends. God's blessings upon you.